Today's show is brought to you by the tone of voice in your head. You know what I'm talking about. In your mind, when you're talking, you sound like this. But in reality, your voice probably sounds more like this. Take a breath and think before you spew. You'll thank me later.
KHJ Los Angeles.
Portions of the day's programming are reproduced by means of electrical transcriptions or tape recording.
You're listening to the radio.
Nice beaver.
Thank you. I just had it stuffed.
Let me help you with that.
That is so stupid.
Comedy is very subjective.
It's one of the reasons that I'm a winner.
Welcome to January 30th.
Welcome back. Today is a very special day.
And I think I smell croissants.
It is National Croissant Day.
Huh. Croissant.
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 Would you like a croissant?
We are celebrating National Croissant Day this morning.
Croissant? Oh, croissants.
It's croissant.
Croissants. I love croissants.
Oh, yeah.
It's showtime.
Croissant? Oh, wee wee. It's the Mike Show. Hi, how you doing? So happy you could join us right here, right now on Radio 434, the Radio 434 apps, and Radio434.com, also on the Alexa.
Hello!
Yep. How do you get our live show and our feature channel on the Alexa? Well, you just simply enable the skill. You just do that one time. You say, Alexa, enable the Radio 434 skill, and she will. And then every time you want to listen after that, you just say, Alexa, play Radio 434. Very simple. You can also get us on the website, radio434.com. Get us on our apps. You can find our podcast after each live show. We repack all the show segments into a full-length podcast. You can find that on, find it on Alexa.
Hello!
Just say, Alexa, play The Mike Show VA podcast, and she will. You can also find us on Apple and Spotify, Amazon Music. You can send us an email right during the show whenever I have that computer potted up. You can find our podcast link on our website as well, radio434.com, and click on it. And we've got, and I'm gonna say this, and I hope I don't jinx it. All right, we are getting very, very, very close to releasing the new app, okay? Yeah.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
And the neat thing about the app is not only will it include the feature channel and include the show live, but it will include the podcast as well, all on the same app. So, now, if you're totally comfortable finding us and you've been listening to us on Apple or Spotify or Amazon Music, that's great. That's wonderful. But you could also get our new app. And if you get the new app, you'll find the podcast there, too. So it's just a great way to connect. And you can watch our show. You'll be able to do that on the app, too, believe it or not. You can watch our show. That's on the Facebook Live at The Mike Show VA. That's all one word, no spaces. At The Mike Show VA on Facebook. Watch us. Long time as well. All right. Coming up on today's program. Let me check my email. Let me see if that was critical information. No. It was just our total care monitoring. Sorry. Yes, I understand. I deliberately shut that channel off. Anywho's. On today's program, of course, we're going to get really smart with your five random facts. We're going to get really, really stupid with your stupid criminals. And today is National Croissant Day. But many people don't know how to pronounce it. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing it properly. So with that, we've got our top list, top ways to pronounce croissant. Okay, that's all on the way. This portion of the broadcast, the show open, is brought to you in part by the YMCA of Central Virginia.
This is Ed. Ed loves the Y. Ed's buddy joined the Y because Ed told him how great the Y is. Now Ed and his buddy both save 20% off of their monthly dues. Ed and his buddy are getting healthy together. Ed refers his other buddies to the Y, too. Now Ed and two of his best buddies are saving on their monthly membership. And you can, too. Not a member? Join today with a friend and you'll both save like Ed. Be healthy, be active, be like Ed. Refer a friend to the Y and save.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their Tap Room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their Tap Room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community, Three Roads Brewery.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
Hey, kid, want to dive into breakfast the prehistoric way?
You bet.
Then try a bowl of Fruity Stone cereal. It's the jawbreaker breakfast experience. Those are real metamorphic rocks, granite chunks, and hunks of real minerals in a kaleidoscope of fruity flavors. What do you think?
Ow.
Are you trying to tell us that Fruity Stone cereal is so fruity crunchy? I guess what you're saying is you're ready for another bowl of Fruity Crunch cereal, right?
Move! This stuff rocks!
Knew you'd love it!
Ow!
Oops! Looks like you spilled some more teeth.
You know, Barney, this stuff isn't bad.
You're right, Fred, but dentally speaking, I think you're yabba-dabba screwed.
New Fruity Stone cereal, part of this complete breakfast.
Mm-hmm. The Mike Show. Hi. How's it going? Did you have your croissant today? Well, that's if you had a bagel this morning, you're doing it wrong. It's National Croissant Day. I think I'm pronouncing that correctly. Well, anyway, it's a French word. It's named after their crescent shape, but they supposedly originated in Austria as early as the 13th century. So now you know. We could only find one national chain running any kind of deals today, but it's actually a pretty good one. And ordinarily, we wouldn't be giving a free plug, but we're going to tell you about it anyway, because I think I'm going to go get one. Burger King is selling their croissant breakfast sandwich for a penny. And they've got seven different types of cross sandwiches, but of course, there's a catch or multiple catches. You just can't pull up to the drive-thru with two rolls of pennies and order 100 of them. You have to be a member of their Royal Perks loyalty, whatever their rewards program is. Order through their website or the app. Spend at least $1. And it only runs until their normal breakfast cutoff, which is 10:30 a.m. at most locations. And this might not even be available at the locations around here. I don't know. I just saw this in the USA Today. Anywho, so that brings us to our top list in honor of National Croissant Day. Here's a fun fact. Nobody really knows how to pronounce it. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing it right. That is until now. Get ready to channel your inner Emily in Paris with today's list, our top list today, top ways to pronounce.
Croissant.
All right, I think, here we go. In English, croissant. Quan-san. Kwanzaa. K-Hu-Kwan. Is that how you pronounce his name? K-Hu-Kwan?
K-Hu-Kwan.
Hui-Kwan. K-Hu-Kwan. Okay. What else? Oh, yeah. Top ways to pronounce croissant. Quantum of solace. Quasimodo. Quadrophenia. I don't know. Koala sex. Carne asada. I don't know. Cunnilingus. What? How do you pronounce that?
Cunnilingus.
I thought it was cunning. I'm a cunning linguist.
Cunnilingus.
She's really upset. Oh, yeah, and how about crocus? There we go. Top ways to pronounce or remember. Croissant. Coming up, on today's program, of course, we're going to get really smart with your five random facts. We've got not headline news. That is on the way. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you by Stonecrafters.
Why should you trust Stonecrafters for your new kitchen and bath? Why not? Your neighbors do. Your friends do. And countless organizations and contractors do. Stonecrafters provided the stone and installation for the new Academy Center of the Arts, historic theater, lobby, box office, concessions, and their new bar upstairs. Visit Stonecrafters, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford, online at stonecraftersva.com. For custom countertops and cabinetry, there's only one choice. Stonecrafters. Your satisfaction is guaranteed in stone.
Need a workout buddy for 2024? Well, now is your chance to save 20% off your monthly dues when you refer a buddy to the YMCA of Central Virginia. When you refer your buddy to the Y and they join the Y, then you will both receive 20% off your monthly dues. You and your buddy can get healthy together while also saving up to $192 a year. Not a member? Join today with a buddy and you both can still save 20% off. Be healthy, be active, and save money by referring a buddy to the YMCA of Central Virginia.
Berg Burritos is back at Cafe Rodora, 1103C Church Street in downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg, with over a dozen different creations to satisfy. For breakfast, check out The Break, a burrito with bacon, scrambled eggs, tater tots, Monterey cheese, sliced avocado, and salsa verde. Or the Chicken Break Burrito, with adobo chicken, scrambled egg, tater tots, Monterey cheese, sliced avocado, and habanero barbecue sauce. How about the Steak Break, a burrito served with thinly sliced ribeye over scrambled eggs, provolone cheese, avocado, tater tots, and salsa verde, each just $10. Order online for fast and easy pickup at RedoraSpecialty.com/cafe or just Google Berg Burritos. Check out their menu and expanded hours for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Berg Burritos, inside Cafe Rodora, 1103C Church Street, downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafters Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafters' incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at StonecraftersVA.com.
KHS. This is not headline news. The Chiefs and the 49ers will face each other in the Super Bowl. But the face we'll see the most is Taylor Swift's. Country stars Eric Church and Morgan Wallen have purchased Field & Stream magazine. And simply by virtue of uttering that sentence, my neck just turned a billion shades redder. Keanu Reeves injured his knee and is now on crutches. He tried to act like it didn't hurt, but as we all know, Keanu can't act. And Phil Collins turned 73 today. Sadly, serious health issues prevent him from performing. But if he could, Phil would be back recording in the Sue studio. This is not headline news.
It's not. It's the Mike Show. Yeah, I mean, with if you look at either Phil Collins or Peter Gabriel, I mean, good Lord, Peter Gabriel's still rocking it out. I mean, and then I was looking at Paul McCartney is 81, Mick Jagger's 80, I realize they've got rich, like mega rich people medical, okay, and they all kinds of procedures and things, I would imagine, but I mean, man, oh man, Mick Jagger though looks incredible. They both look incredible. What am I talking about? I'm this fat guy at 50, almost 57, and I look old, and they don't. They look great. Well, I mean, especially for being in their 80s. Anyway, we digress. What were we talking about? I don't know. Anyway, Phil Collins. Man, that's sad. It really is. But Peter Gabriel, let's find out, how old is Peter Gabriel? How old is Peter Griffin? How old is Peter Gabriel? Peter Gabriel's 73. So they're both the same age. Phil Collins, 73. Mike Rutherford, 73. Peter Gabriel, 73. All in the band Genesis. All right. So what about this? If aliens showed up tomorrow and they were not overly friendly about it, who would you want to be the point person in charge of talking it out with them? who should we trust? Okay. In a new poll, 43% say they would be cool with our current world leaders representing Earth.
I said our current world leaders.
They didn't specify who that would be, so maybe our options are President Biden, Xi Jinping. How do you pronounce? I guess he's from
China.
Hello.
Hi. How do you pronounce that? Yeah, he is the president of the People's Republic of China. How to pronounce? All right, here we go. Oh man, it's not our Pronouncify lady. It's this YouTube dude. Here, let's see.
We are looking at how to pronounce the name of this Chinese politician who has served as a General Secretary of the Communist Party of China and Chairman of the Central Military Commission since 2012. He has also been, of course, the President of the People's Republic of China since 2013.
Yep, get to it.
We are looking at how to pronounce Xi Jinping.
Okay.
Xi Jinping.
Okay, great. Thank you. So him, Vladimir Putin, Emmanuel Macron, or King Charles. Are we sure about this? Anyway, we can't ask Taylor Swift to do it, since, Travis's Super Bowl is coming up. And Elliot from E.T. was just a fictional character. So what about you? Yeah, you. In the poll, 42% of Americans say yes, they believe they would be able to negotiate peace with aliens. Thank you. 37% of people say they believe aliens are already here, while 41% do not think there are aliens among us. The other 22% just don't know. Overall, 53% of people think that aliens do exist somewhere, while 34% of people don't believe in extraterrestrial life. Thanks. All right. Me negotiate with the aliens. Okay. I'd rather think about this. Would you dip your pizza into guacamole? A major food brand desperately wants us to start. Hormel Foods owns the brand Holy Guacamole, and they're behind this push. They did a poll that found 74% of us would reach for guacamole at a Super Bowl party. 91% would reach for pizza, but only 17% have tried them together. I don't think I've ever dipped pizza into guacamole. I don't even think I've dipped pizza crust into guacamole. I like ranch on my pizza sometimes, and obviously I love the what am I thinking of? The pizza sauce. I like that, but with the crust. I've never tried guacamole. Anyway, they're holding a contest and launched a website called guacifypizza.com. 250 fans in San Francisco and Kansas City will win free pizza and guacamole on Super Bowl Sunday. Oh, that's a bummer. So why? It's just a dumb marketing thing? Or does guac on pizza actually sound good to you? I don't know. I don't know. I mean, if I haven't tried it, then, probably not good. Now I'm curious. Some decisions are big and require lots of time and considerations. Others are not big, but we struggle with them. Anyway, a new poll looked at the top everyday decisions we struggle with. Here are the top 10. Let's do it from the bottom up, because that's the way I like to do it. Social related decisions, 18%. Like, do you really want to grab a drink with a friend or just keep flipping through the TV? Personal hygiene. Also at 18%. Like, that's even a question? Number nine. These are, decisions that, everyday decisions that people struggle with. Oh, like, do you have time to take a shower? Okay. How to organize your day. That's number eight on the list. 25% of folks said that they struggle with these decisions. Number seven on the list, whether spending money on something is worth it. That's 31%. Your morning routine and what order to do stuff, 32%. I am extremely OCD, and it's not a ritual thing. It's not like if you throw a monkey wrench into my schedule, I'll go all Rain Man on you and ask for VERN. But I do have a certain set order in which I like to do things. And then Tab, yep, she's been getting up earlier now to work out. And that has totally thrown a monkey wrench into my schedule, meaning as soon as she gets up and she's, the lights on, and I'm like, I really wanted to hit the snooze button and sleep in a little bit longer, but maybe I shouldn't, so now I gotta get up. Oh, but wait, there's more. Go ahead and get dressed to take the dog out so he's not underneath my pedals while I'm on the Peloton. Exactly. 32% are struggling with your morning routine. What to buy at the store? That's 36% of folks said that. That's number five. What to wear? 37%. Number four. Decisions related to a hobby you have. 39% of folks struggle with that. What to watch on the TV? That's 40%. And what to eat? 44% have trouble deciding on any given day. The poll also looked at the top big decisions we take our time with. The top five, obviously, are buying a house, getting married or divorced, having kids, changing jobs, and moving. 27% regret a big decision they made when they were young. 27% also regret a decision about their career. 23% regret something about their significant other. And 22% regret certain parenting decisions that they have made. All that. All right. Coming up, we are going to get really, really smart with your five random facts. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle, trade in with us, and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
How about this for a New Year's resolution? Invest in your home. Update that kitchen and bathroom with a visit to Stonecrafters. According to realtors, homes with updated kitchens and bathrooms sell 54% faster and for more money. Plus, you have to live there, and there's no greater investment, especially right now, than your own home. Stonecrafters has the largest selection of stone in stock, rows and rows towering throughout their factory direct warehouse. Plus, a great selection of remnants in stock, too, that can save you money. And right now, for a limited time, Stonecrafters will give you a free vanity top for your bathroom or bar with the purchase and installation of your new kitchen from Stonecrafters. Visit Stonecrafters for details. 3678 Manita Road in Bedford, StonecraftersVA.com. And they do it all from start to finish, from laser measuring your space, designing your project, cutting your stone right there in their warehouse, and installing your new kitchen and bathroom in days. For custom countertops and cabinetry, there's only one choice, Stonecrafters. Your satisfaction is guaranteed in Stone.
There's nothing like holding a freshly grilled Jersey Mike's cheesesteak. It's even better than holding a winning $1 million lottery ticket. For starters, Uncle Sam takes half. Then you buy some useless stuff, like a tiny suit of armor for your cat. And before you know it, your sister's cousins and Uncle Frankie come knocking on your door for handouts. Bing, bang, boom, you're back to zero. So if you want to play a winning number, order a number 17 Mike's Famous Philly. Freshly grilled right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
And now, it's time for...
Five!
Random
facts.
Yep, that time of the day we cram your head full of usable information. You can tell it back wherever the heck you happen to be. Now, when you do this, somebody in the room just might say,
wow.
I don't know, maybe. Here we go, number one. Astronomers say the Milky Way smells like rum and tastes like strawberries. How?
How would they know?
What the Milky Way...
tastes like Milky Way bars.
Oh, the actual galaxy. Number two, technically, Bruce Springsteen has never had a number one hit. The closest was Dancing in the Dark at number two in 1984, but a song he wrote was number one. Manfred Mann hit number one in 1977 with a cover of Blinded by the Light. Number three, the Coen brothers based the movie Oh Brother, Where Art Thou on the Odyssey, but neither of them ever read it. They just knew the basic plot and all the highlights from all the references in pop culture. Number four, the famous pediatrician and author Dr. Benjamin Spock won a gold medal in rowing in 1924 in the Olympics. Plus, he had pointy ears. No, different Spock. And then number five, the point in North America that is furthest from any ocean is in the southwest corner of South Dakota. It's 1,024 miles from the nearest coastline. And those are your five random facts. It's the Mike Show. Coming up a little bit later on, we've got your audio vault. Then we've got your Stoopid Criminalz in dot news. That's all on the way.
This has been today's edition of...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Random facts.
Yep. All right. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike's Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy, because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea. Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Join us down at the Lynchburg Community Market and experience all that one of the nation's oldest farmers markets has to offer. Grab some lunch from our restaurants and shops, or shop from our awesome selection of artisan, handmade goods in our crafters gallery. Swing by on Saturday to check out our farmers market, where you can shop from the freshest selection of local grown produce, meats, and more. The Lynchburg Community Market, located in downtown Lynchburg on the corner of 12th and Main Street. Open Tuesday through Saturday from 7 to 2 year-round. For more information, follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
Berg Burritos is back at Cafe Rodora, 1103C Church Street in downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg, with over a dozen different creations to satisfy. How about the Faux-rito, seasoned deep-fried tofu, shaved ribeye and sautéed red peppers and onions, fried glass noodles, cucumbers, and bean sprouts with sweet chili sauce mixed inside. Or the Tort Burrito, a limited-time burrito with spicy deep-fried cheese tortellini, adobo chicken, red peppers, and house-made queso. How about the carnita? Slow-cooked pork carnitas with seasoned rice, black beans, shredded red cabbage, Monterey cheese, and corn pico. Order online for fast and easy pickup at RedoraSpecialty.com/cafe or just Google Berg Burritos. Check out their menu and expanded hours for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Berg Burritos, inside Cafe Redora, 1103C Church Street, downtown Lynchburg. The best burritos in the Berg.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF. It is the Mike Show. It's the Tuesday edition of the program that brings us Megan Huffman from SHARE Greater Lynchburg. Hi.
Hello, Mike. How are you?
Doing really, really well.
Great.
Each and every Tuesday, Megan stops by and she brings us a guest. Today is no exception. Who did you bring?
Yes, I'm delighted to have Bailey Mooney. She is with Big Brothers Big Sisters and serves as the outreach and recruitment coordinator over there. And we've just been hearing about how there's some kids out there that are waiting for mentors, and wow, we want to solve that, right?
Yeah, so absolutely.
And we believe in the Share Greater Lynchburg community. We can fix this. So Bailey's here to talk about what that looks like. What does mentorship look like? Yeah. And what how do you sign up?
Yeah. Well, Bailey, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate you taking time today. Tell us about your organization, and then tell us about the program.
Yes. Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely.
You guys kind of said, I work with Big Brothers Big Sisters, which is basically a mentorship program. Our mission is to positively impact the youth in our community by providing them with a one-to-one mentor, you know, a caring adult who can be a positive role model for them and kind of have this positive impact in their life. And the primary way that we do that is through two programs that we offer. So one of them is called our community-based program, and then the other one is called our site-based program. So I'll kind of go into the community-based program first. What that is it's going to be about an 8-hour a month commitment for, the mentors. And what they do is they are matched with a child in our community who is just in need of that, you know, relationship with an adult who's going to care about them. And so basically there's a lot of freedom for the mentors in this program to, you know, kind of take their little wherever they want, kind of do whatever they want with them. A lot of mentors in this program use weekends to do this because, I mean, once every weekend, you know, in the month, you can spend 2 hours with your little and easily meet that 8-hour commitment. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times our mentors say that, you know, it's really surprising how easy it is to meet that 8-hour minimum. Yeah. It kind of sounds like a lot off the bat, but really it's not that much of a time commitment.
And now if you go to see a Marvel movie,
right,
you can knock it out in just one sitting.
Exactly. Right. Yeah, exactly. And so, I mean, a lot of our mentors in this program are people with jobs, with families, with other commitments. And this program works really well because you just get to take your little along with you in your daily life. It's not something that you have to, you know, plan some extravagant event, you know, every weekend. You really just get to kind of absorb this child kind of into what you're already doing.
Okay.
Bailey, what's the typical age of these age range of these children?
So we serve children from ages 6 to 16.
Okay.
Yeah, so those are kind of where we will match. However, if you are matched with a child, we keep that match open until they are 18.
Okay.
Great.
Yeah.
About how many kids right now are kind of on a waiting list?
Yeah, so we have upwards of about 20 to 30 kids just wow, waiting to be matched right now.
Oh, my.
Yeah, yeah, so there's a lot.
Okay. Folks can go to Share Greater Lynchburg, and I've got the link popped up here on the page. And if you type in Big Brothers Big Sisters of Central Virginia, you can learn more about the volunteer opportunities and then events and things like that that are going on. Mm-hmm. Well, and speaking of which, you guys have an event coming up.
Yeah, yeah. So we have Bowl for Kids Sake, which is on March 23rd. And so basically that is just kind of one of our big fundraising events of the year to raise money to support just the programs that we offer, to come alongside both the bigs and the littles, as well as their families, to just kind of keep what we do going. So that's... yeah, what we got going on.
That's great. We have that on the website as well. So you mentioned that there was a community-based program, and then there's a site-based program.
Yes.
So is that is it more after school?
Yes. So our site-based program, there are basically kind of two facets to this. There is an after-school program, which works well for what we call our high school bigs program, because high school students in our community can mentor kids.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Okay. So that is kind of after school in the community centers, Jubilee and Boys and Girls Club.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. However, another facet of this program is taking time out of your day to have lunch with your little while they are at school.
Okay.
So this is something that works well for maybe adults who are working full-time jobs. Maybe their weekends are, you know, pretty busy, but they can take an hour a week to have lunch with their little. So the site-based program is a requirement of 4 hours a month. That breaks down to 1 hour a week for you to spend time with your little. And, you know, going to eat lunch with them at school is a really good way to do that.
Yeah, that sounds really doable. Just pick a certain day of the week and meet once a week for lunch with your little. That's great.
Yeah,
that is fantastic.
Awesome. Well, thank you. We'll put all this in the SHARE Greater Lynchburg newsletter this week with links for how to get involved. But I feel certain we can, you know, secure some new mentors through these channels. So that's wonderful.
Absolutely. And that would be tremendous. Mm-hmm. Again, you can learn more by going to sharegreaterlynchburg.org. Type in Big Brothers Big Sisters of Central Virginia. It brings up a few different options, including upcoming events and a wish list. You can make a purchase on behalf of Big Brothers Big Sisters right there on the website. Have the items delivered. Whatever the organizations need, it's right there on Share Greater Lynchburg. So, Megan.
Yeah.
You were out of town.
Yep.
Back into it.
Back here.
What's all going on?
Yeah. So we're closing in on the really January is about planning, right? And so we're getting ready to step into February. So this Thursday's newsletter will feature all of our lunch and learns for the year. Okay. It will have all of our upcoming mixer, a night at the Hillcats ballpark. You know, there's a lot of great things that have been laid into place this month that will be coming out in our Thursday newsletter. So it's one you don't want to miss. And for the Greater Lynchburg Community Foundation, we're entering into the season of grant applications. This Thursday, February 1st, we kick off our Century Fund application. That's a $100,000 grant that's given out once a year to one nonprofit. And that is open only the month of February to apply.
Really?
So so it starts on Thursday. And we just want to make sure to get the word out that that is open. We also have scholarships coming open for students in the region to apply for. We have a lot of specific designated scholarships that are that have been made by generous donors in our community, have started funds to promote these scholarships. And so we want to make sure that the high schoolers in our region are aware of the great scholarship opportunities that we have. And then our deadline for our spring cycle of grants will be March 15th. And so really in the next, 6 weeks is a big grant making or grant applying time for the foundation. And so we're just trying to get the word out. We had a record setting 97 applications for our fall cycle.
That's
and
tremendous.
I have to believe that just getting the word out and trying to spread the word about these opportunities and it only makes everyone do better. So we're looking forward to this time of grant making.
Absolutely. How much in a year's period of time, how much in dollar amounts does the foundation award?
Last year was $2.2
million.
Wow. So that's scholarships, grant cycle, two grant cycles, and the special grants as well. So it's it only keeps growing as generous. We had a great end of year and a lot of amazing donors that are contributing to add to that pot. And so that number only is getting larger and we, as the need goes up, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. You can learn more by visiting lynchburgfoundation.org for the Greater Lynchburg Community Foundation. The application for grants and scholarships, all the information, even the Youth Philanthropy Council, all that information is right there on the website, and check it out. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for taking time. Find out more about Big Brothers Big Sisters. I know there are plenty of opportunities. There are plenty of kids that need that connection. Mm-hmm. And it's great work that you guys do. So learn more by visiting Share Greater Lynchburg. Thanks so much. We'll talk to you again soon.
Thanks, Mike.
Thanks.
It is the Mike Show coming up a little bit later on. We've got your audio vault. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Megan Huffman with SHARE Greater Lynchburg. SHARE is an online platform that helps neighbors discover ways to support, serve, or shop for over 150 local area nonprofits all in one place, 365 days a year. You can learn more at sharegreaterlynchburg.org.
Getting a Jersey Mike's sub top Mike's way with onion, lettuce, tomatoes, oregano, and the juice is the bee's knees. Actually, it's better than the bee's knees. I mean, what's the purpose of knees on bees? They don't crouch, they just buzz around. But Mike's way has a purpose, topping your sub the authentic Jersey way. It's the cat's pajamas. Wait, cats don't wear pajamas. Mike's way is better. Let's just leave it at that. Get your sub top Mike's way. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
Okie dokie. Open it up. It's your audio vault for today. Our collection of bits and clips and viral audio for your ear holes. Well, it's the audio from viral videos, some of it. Anyway, there are 118 brand new emojis coming to iPhones, including new foods, animals, and gender-neutral families. If you got an old Mac smartphone, it might be time to update.
Texting messages is about to get a lot more interesting.
Your Mac iPhone, did you know? Emojis will grow. Gender neutral, here we go. Emojis will grow. With a head shake here and a phoenix there. Gender skin tone adding to your smartphone. Your Mac iPhone has a farm. Limes and mushrooms grow.
Okay, great. Let's see. Do you want to get free food at restaurants? Well, I guess here's one way to do it. Listen to this TikToker's advice.
How hard is it to sign up to become a secret shopper? Essentially, businesses hire somebody to secretly come in as a diner, and they ask this person to look out for certain things. How many minutes until your drink is dropped after you order it? Did the server offer you dessert? Was your cutlery clean? And then you go home and you write a report and you send it into the restaurant, and they will reimburse the cost of your food up to a certain point and sometimes pay you additionally on top of that. You had to read the report ahead of time, and then it would take 30 minutes to write it up. It was so fun because you felt like a spy undercover. The website I used was called isecretshop.com.
All right. So there are a bunch of sites that are out there that do this, but the one that she used, again, was secretshop.com. Skip that. We're going to save that for stupid criminals. Okay. So there's a documentary now that's about the making of the 1985 charity song We Are the World. It just began streaming on Netflix. It's called The Greatest Night in Pop. The recording session was packed with the biggest names in music at the time in 1985. Also famous are the people who were not there. For instance, Madonna was not even invited. Here is Harriet Sternberg from the documentary explaining who her boss, one of the producers of the song, Ken Cragen, wanted instead.
I wanted Madonna. Material Girl and all of the things she did would bring a really different audience. But Ken wanted Cindy. We had a fight about that.
I felt, you know, it was an important thing to do. I do believe that rock and roll can save the world, or we should try.
All right, so Cyndi Lauper instead. Now, speaking of Cyndi Lauper, when they recorded We Are the World, all the artists got a demo in advance. Some of them didn't think it was a very good song. It was recorded right after the American Music Awards. Lionel Richie was one of the hosts, or was the host, and Cyndi Lauper was winning awards on stage that night. She actually wanted to bail on the session.
Backstage, Cyndi Lauper came over to me and said, "My boyfriend heard the song. I'm not going to be able to come because he doesn't think it's a hit."
Well, nobody knew. It certainly was a group of great people, but I was so punch drunk tired.
Well, it's some year, huh?
And after the show, it was like, all right, you have to just go there.
And I said, "Cyndi, it's pretty important for you to make the right decision. Don't miss the session tonight."
All right. In the new documentary, Lionel Richie has a great story about getting scared while writing We Are the World over at Michael Jackson's house.
We Are the World was probably a line from Michael.
We are the world.
Out of the corner of my eye, I see some albums falling over, and I hear, I look over my shoulder. That's the biggest snake. And Michael's going, there he is, Lionel. Oh, my God. He lost the snake in the room. He came out when he heard us singing, Lionel, and he wanted to meet you. He wants to say hello to you. I gotta get out of here quick. I am screaming like this is the end. I saw this horror movie, and it's not good for the brother.
No, it is not. Let's see. Was there another Michael Jackson bit? Quincy Jones had already produced some of Michael Jackson's biggest albums when he produced We Are the World. The new documentary has part of an interview where Quincy says Michael didn't even want to sing on it.
First, Michael didn't want to sing or be on the video. He thought it was overexposure at first. I talked Michael into being on the date, you know. That would have been one of the biggest mistakes in his career if he hadn't showed up.
We are the world.
But he was there, man.
We are the children.
He was more than there.
We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start giving. How does it sound?
Sounds great, man.
Now, I want to know a huge artist that decided not to take part? Prince. He had just beaten Michael that night with some of the American Music Awards. So he was a no-show. One artist almost had a nervous breakdown while recording We Are the World. It was Bob Dylan. When it came time for his solo vocal, he had no idea how to sing it. He finally asked if Stevie Wonder could sit at the piano and help.
Stevie, can you play it one time?
The secret agent to help him get comfortable was Stevie Wonder. Stevie sang it ventriloquially in Dylan's voice. Dylan was probably more uncomfortable than any other person that was here.
There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's true, we make a better day. Just you and me.
Who was the only artist to walk out during the We Are the World sessions? Who? Well, listen to this and find out.
Stevie said, I think we need to have some Swahili somewhere in this song. I think we should sing Tutu Wainono Willy Moingu.
I was back in the corner of the room, just happened to be pretty close to Waylon Jennings, and, well, ain't no good old boy ever sung Swahili. I think I'm out of here.
Just a good old boy.
Waylon walks out of the door. I'm not dealing with it. I don't know what that means, but I am not going to say it, and we lost Waylon right there.
His buddy Willie Nelson obviously stayed. Let's see. Is that all the ones that we have for the We Are the World? Yep. All right. So that is airing on Netflix. It's called The Greatest Night in Pop. Turning to another great television event, David Letterman. We have a YouTube video, one of his YouTube videos. Talking about the backlash about Taylor Swift and her boyfriend.
So now here's Taylor Swift, who is a glowing bright light of goodness in the world, and she starts dating Kelsey Grammer. And people...
No, that's not true.
What?
Kelsey Grammer?
Yes. And the Kelsey Grammer people say, oh, no, 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 don't bother us. And the Taylor Swift people, the Swifties, are saying, oh, we don't want a footballer in here with Kelsey Grammer. And I'm saying,
Kelsey.
Huh?
Travis Kelsey.
Right, Travis Kelsey. And I say to both camps, this is such a lovely thing. Shut up. It's good for the footballers.
Yeah.
It's good for Taylor Swift. And it's something positive and happy for the world. Taylor Swift is a huge force and I think just wants to see people do the right thing. So God bless Taylor Swift. And Kelsey Grammer. That's
not
all
Kelsey
I had.
Kelsey Grammer.
Not Kelsey Grammer. All right. From the confused to the possibly delusional, Kanye lost it When Melanie from TMZ approached him on Hollywood Boulevard yesterday, he snatched her cell phone while she was recording. We got this audio from a different person's phone. During the altercation, Kanye, who was wearing a black mask over his entire head, berated her for asking about his wife. He went on to credit himself as a superhero.
Hey, Kanye, people want to know if Bianca has her free will. Some people are saying you're controlling her.
Would you think that you, a white woman, you could walk up on me like that and ask me some dumb like that? Asking me about my wife, talking about does she get free will? Are you crazy? You insane? This is America. You got free will? You working for TMZ Company? I'm a legend. You understand that? I'm here to support Charlie Wilson. You come to ask me some dumb about my wife. That's my wife. You understand what I'm saying? No, tell me. Was it wrong for you to ask me, was that wrong or right?
I'm sorry, Kanye. I just need my phone.
No, no. Answer the question. I'm supposed to answer your questions? Answer my question. I got your phone now. They going to arrest me for taking your phone? Arrest me for taking your phone then.
I don't...
You answer the question. You asked me, did my wife have free will? Was that a dumb, disrespectful question to come ask a grown superhero? What is your first and last name and address, Mitch?
What are we doing?
I just need my phone.
I'll pay you double what they paying you.
Woo!
Now you smile.
Woo!
Get a contact.
Yes, I will. I will.
Thank you, Kanye.
Good Lord. All right, skip that. We're gonna wrap it up with a comedian, as we do each and every audio vault. Here's comedian Nick Griffin on lazy attire.
Thank you. This is such a great honor and really nice. And the first thing I did all day. It's true. I woke up, I put on my sweatpants, and I ran out of steam. I guess a lot of us do that, right? It's something about the sweatpants, I don't know. Here's the deal, if you don't work out in your sweatpants, they're not sweatpants. They're failure slacks. And I know there's, young people in the audience, and they're probably thinking, that's sad. When I get to be his age, I'm going to be active. I'm going to meet the right person and get the right job and be in the right shape. No, you're not. You're going to wear sweatpants.
All right. That's your audio vault for today. Let's reach over here and lovingly grab the handle. Go ahead. Give it a tug. Keep all that sound inside. Coming up, let's do Stoopid. Let's get really, really, really dumb. That is all on the way with your Stoopid Criminalz in the news. Plus, we've got a good news story for you as well. That is all coming up. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by the YMCA of Central Virginia.
This is Ed. Ed loves the Y. Ed's buddy joined the Y because Ed told him how great the Y is. Now Ed and his buddy both save 20% off of their monthly dues. Ed and his buddy are getting healthy together. Ed refers his other buddies to the Y too. Now Ed and two of his best buddies are saving on their monthly membership. And you can too. Not a member? Join today with a friend and you'll both save like Ed. Be healthy, be active, be like Ed. Refer a friend to the Y and save.
Hi, I'm Matt Bright, the new owner of CRI Digital Impressions. And I'm excited to announce a new chapter in the century-long history of CRI. Mutual Press was founded in 1927, and in 1973 it merged with CRI to become CRI Mutual Press. In 2002, it was renamed CRI Digital Impressions. I also own Bright Images, which has provided print and media services to the area since 1995. Yes, there is a new owner and a new location, but the same commitment to quality and service. In fact, quality and service are the cornerstones of my business philosophy. Quick turns and service with a smile. From business cards to banners and pamphlets to paperback books, we can provide all your printing needs. Call, visit us online, or stop by our location at 3022 Memorial Avenue, Lynchburg. We look forward to serving you.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their Tap Room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their Tap Room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community, Three Roads Brewery.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF. All right, time once again for Stoopid Criminalz in the News. This almost sounds like the setup to a joke, but it's oh so real. A naked woman walked into a convenience store armed with a potato peeler on Sunday. Yes, it happened in Florida. And yes, she was drunk. 35-year-old Celia Barrett waltzed into a store in St. Petersburg Sunday evening and started yelling about getting kicked out of the same store a day earlier. She threatened two workers with the peeler and said she was going to kill one of them with a potato peeler. Is that even possible? Anyway, she also toppled a display of Red Bulls, tore open a carton of cigarettes, spilling them on the floor. An employee called the police, and she was still fully naked when they arrived. She also started...
let's see. Do I have a sound effect for this? Where's the thingy? No, not that. Oh, yeah, the clown horn. She started practicing self-love in front of the officers.
Nice beaver.
Thank you. I just had it stuffed.
Let me help you with that.
Hopefully not with the potato peeler. She told them that she had 6 shots of liquor. She's facing charges for aggravated assault, disorderly conduct, trespassing, criminal mischief, and... indecent exposure. And then there is this. You may have seen this, but a police officer in Oklahoma pulled someone over on the highway this month and was talking to them through their passenger side window when an SUV plowed into their car at full speed. How no one died in this insane car crash, we don't understand. The left side of the car got obliterated. The SUV rolled. The officer was thrown 10 feet from the car. Here's the stop, the crash, and the officer radioing for help.
Yeah, not taking you to jail.
City, I was just hit by a car.
Oh, man. Good Lord. Now, somehow, again, no one was seriously hurt. Police posted the video hoping to make us all more mindful about distracted driving. And then a Domino's pizza delivery driver in Colorado was caught on camera stealing a package after dropping off a pizza. Here's the victim, Anthony Torres, talking about getting his package stolen.
It made me very nervous and kind of tell that he was truly trying to see what else was available. We've had other incidences here where things weren't clear on the camera, but this was pretty clear. Perhaps there's desperate and whatever, but at the same time, there's right and there's wrong, and this is not right. It could really do some harm to people, and it can harm our overall community if this is something that isn't stopped or people aren't aware.
Mm-hmm. There's good news in the world, and we like to share it during this particular segment because there is so much stupidity. A California bride who called off her wedding decided to donate the entire $15,000 reception to a good cause. The anonymous bride
gave the party to Parents Helping Parents, which supports families with children living with disabilities. Here is Maria Dane, the executive director of that organization, talking about the gift.
I think this donation is extraordinary. I've never heard of anyone ever calling a nonprofit and saying, we want to donate a $15,000 party in 2 weeks to you. And just thrilled that we will be able to have an event for families.
And there you go. That is the good news. This portion of the broadcast, the good news especially, is brought to you in part by the United Way of Central Virginia.
42% of Virginia's kindergartners entered kindergarten without the resources needed to be successful. With the help of United Way, 5,630 books were mailed to 550 children enrolled in Dolly Parton's Imagination Library.
One of the reasons I chose United Way over other nonprofits is its ability to reach and connect with all members of the Greater Lynchburg community. I am the change, and you can be the change too.
Visit our website, Be the Change, and donate today.
All right, visit unitedwaycv.org. And before we wrap up, I want to share this with you as well. You can join us broadcasting live and on location this Thursday, 5 to 7 p.m. for happy hour, February 1st. It is our first mic'd up pop-up concert of February with Chris Shepherd. He's going to be joining us out there at Three Roads, 1300 Court Street in downtown Lynchburg, their Lynchburg Tap Room. And you can enjoy happy hour with us, happy hour pricing on specific Three Roads brews. And we'll have prizes and giveaways as well. We're going to be playing Yes or BS. We'll be playing the couples game. We'll be playing a brand new game that I just invented. It's called Prize or Nothing. Yep, we get the prize wheel. And I'm always a little anxious when we start talking about using the prize wheel, because there are so many, you know, sections on the prize wheel, right? And we have to figure out, okay, well, can we come up with 12 different prizes and a lot of them, you know, so that when people win, you know, they feel like they did well and they walk away with something. Well, no.
I said no. No.
Thank you. That's not the way this game works. This game, we have one prize section on the wheel. The rest of them are empty. So you've got a 1 in 12 chance of actually landing on prize. And if you do, then you get to pick from our prizes. See? I think it's an extremely great way of doing things. Rather than loading the whole wheel up with all kinds of different prizes and everybody that spins gets something, no. No, we're not doing that. You get prize or nothing. Nothing. Anyway, but that's coming up. Chris Shepherd, if you saw Chris, if you heard Chris on our show, if you saw him out and about at any of our happy hours, Chris played I think twice already in 2023. He's just phenomenal. He's a comedic musician. He also does covers of regular songs, but he has some really, really funny ones that he likes to share. And February starts his month of songwriting. So this is actually the month that he starts writing new material, and he's going to join us on February 1st. So this Thursday, 5 to 7, you can come on out and join us at Three Roads for Happy Hour, 1300 Court Street, for the Mic'd Up Pop-Up Concert Series, and we hope you'll join us. Well, that is it. That is the program. We are back tomorrow.
Goodbye.
Don't come back.
Now we're back tomorrow with another thrilling edition of The Mike Show. Have a great day, everybody.
Thanks for tuning our way, and if you're listening in your car right now, thanks for the ride.
Scotty, beam me up.
We'll see you here again tomorrow.
Who's going to do the dishes?